About every day, we talk about drug activity in our newscast.
One way it impacts you is right here on the roads. You're looking at a case on I-71 just north of Cincinnati. Anchor Kristen Hartman got the piece of dash cam video from the Ohio State Highway Patrol.
Yeah, Tanya, and they tell me the man they were chasing in the middle of the afternoon used marijuana and then got behind the wheel. As a result, you have some hair-raising, gasp-worthy moments on a well-traveled highway. And keep this in mind, this is just one case in thousands across the state.
Pages of crash stats, and behind every number is a person.
These aren't numbers, these are lives.
One December day, it was Elder High School teacher Mark Klusman hit while doing volunteer work. His eventual passing broke hearts.
One of the most Christian men you would ever meet. Just an icon of Western Hills, and just such a loss to lose him.
The woman who pled guilty in Klusman's case, according to court documents, admitted to smoking marijuana just prior to driving and crashing that Saturday morning.
The drug-impaired drivers aren't only out there at night with the bar crowd. It's not the old 10 to 2 a.m. is when your impaired drivers are out there. It's 24 hours a day now, and people need to be cognizant of that.
The scary example we showed you just north of Cincinnati on I-71 happened at about 2:30 in the afternoon. It's not unique. We know that because starting in 2015, the Ohio State Highway Patrol decided to really track the problem. Now it has 2 full years of data it shared with 9 on Your Side.
If there was one word to describe the issue that we're talking about, what would it be for you?
Tragic. It would be tragic.
You don't think you should be driving?
And Hamilton County tops the preventative pain list. For 2 years, it's had the most drug OVI crashes in the state. Butler County rounded out the top 5 both years. The goal is to bring down those numbers.
This is the DRE kit.
So 221 drug recognition experts like Trooper Matthew Schaub are on the front lines working to get drug impaired drivers off Ohio's roads.
As a DRE, I take blood pressure and pulses. So I got a stethoscope and a blood pressure cuff.
Wow.
As a part of the 12-step evaluation process.
We rode along with Trooper Schaub.
You just don't know who's out there driving and what they're on. It's very unnerving.
To be able to show you what he sees and how he searches.
You know, I personally work Green Township because of the high number of OVI crashes and arrests that are down here.
The main focus I'm looking for is people that are swerving, you know, driving outside their lane.
So it's just before midnight. We've been on the road about an hour and 45 minutes, and already we have one drug-related arrest. Trooper, what happened there?
We saw the car pull out of the gas station.
Uh-huh.
No headlights on in the middle of the night. We stopped him.
When he did, Schaub says he smelled raw marijuana. He asked the driver and his passenger to step out of the car.
Your friend back there said there's weed in the car, so we're going to search it.
And it wasn't long before he found this baggie of weed and non-prescribed Adderall. Schaub says the driver was sober. He was not impaired, but he faces a felony possession charge.
Sign of the times?
Yeah, I mean, drug possession, it's everywhere.
Has drug impairment behind the wheel increased?
Oh, definitely.
The Ohio State Highway Patrol numbers show drug-related OVI arrests almost doubled from some 3,000 cases in 2016 to more than 6,000 in 2017.
As law enforcement, we've recognized a problem. We've trained our people to be better at detecting drug-impaired drivers. Mm-hmm. So there is a little bit of a correlation there that we have gotten better. Therefore, the numbers are rising.
Numbers that help them pinpoint enforcement. Turns out some hours are more of an issue than others. The data trend from 2017 shows starting at 11 in the morning, drugged driving crashes increased hourly, then dipped slightly after peaking from 5 to 6.
They're blending in with all the rush hour traffic.
That is shocking because you think everybody's coming home from work.
The 5 to 6 60-minute stretch had 298 drug OVI crashes, second only to the high of 302 between 9 and 10 in the evening. The whole 24-hour cycle takes a human toll. Ohio's drug OVI crashes claimed 179 souls last year.
It's the worst thing that we have to do is inform anybody that they've lost a loved one.
And injuries ran into the thousands.
What should you, as a driver who's sharing the roads with these folks, know?
If they see something, they gotta call us.
Well, have a good night, guys, okay? Be careful driving for me.
call once you get out of the way of the other driver. And when we say call, you or preferably a passenger can dial 911 or pound 677 to let police know what you see. Back to that case on I-71, dispatchers received several calls from the public about the driver, so folks did their witness duty. No one died in the crash, but it did involve two other motorists, Craig. Some